Let's be honest. Half the people that quit, they came back the next week. Let's go on. I'm looking at you.
Hello guys, it's Hyperion with an E here, and today I'll be showcasing and reviewing the pretty new event white, the Crystallized Fangs Venom. Event whites are whites which drop from realm encounters, so these guys and all of them drop something special. Okay, some don't. Seedirk gets a pass because of its beautiful sprite. Let me bite wag that. Anyways, with the addition of the Fungal Cavern update, we got the Dwarf Miner, which is a new encounter. It's been out for a few months, so I'm sure most of you are familiar with it. He poses a fair challenge for an encounter, and like the other encounters, he drops an event white. This exact one my beautiful assassin is holding. So the Dwarf Miner is the only way you can get it, right? Well, here's how I got it. Yep, I was cheeky enough to snag it off the keeper. It felt good. Like, really good. Now some people are like, Damn, I said like way too many times. But it ruins the excitement of event whites. But hey, I hunted down over 300 of these bad boys, and all I care about is Ogma or the poison. So it didn't kill any of the excitement for me, as I don't have too much time to play. And I thought this item was possibly a myth like the Ogma. Like seriously, I did. Oh my god, I keep saying like this, please forgive me. But I did 5 Ogmas worth of Lottles. And I still don't have an Ogma. Anyways, all event whites shift an aspect of your gameplay by a lot. The Helm of the Juggernaut cuts off the ability to be speedy on a warrior, but it gives you double armor, so you transform from a speedy brute to an absolute tank. Oreo sacrifices raising HP for a brief moment of invulnerability. Quiver of Thunder, yes, this counts as an event white, sacrifices spamming quivers that immobilize your enemies and sacrifices damage for you to daze enemies and help the entire group in another way. The Ray Katana sacrifices a fair amount of DPS to go to the rubbish bin. This poison, Armor Breaks. It's the second poison for Assassin to give out a debuff. Generally, Assassin poisons are just dealing damage differently, whether it be super high damage concentrated to a small radius of Murky, or lesser damage on a big crowd with a Plague Poison, or just spawn little jellyfish and do an aura of damage. But now, Assassin can armor break consistently, just like the Shield of Ogma. So remember when everyone said Assassin was useless aside from instating bosses and was a leech class? Why the Assassin is stupid? Now if you have the poison, you are a certified Fangster. Before a recent patch, this poison had a big drawback. The poison didn't give any stat bonuses, did a fair amount of damage, 750, and still armor broke, but at the cost of a lengthy cooldown on the throws and armor breaking yourself. Yikes. I still liked it because the armor breaking is a rare debuff. When you're in a realm doing dungeons and all, you don't see enemies being armor broken much because the only sources of armor breaks are 2 event whites and one is hard to get. And one of the other sources is a limited time ring, which is really hard to get and it doesn't even apply it consistently. So I still wanted it heaps and I got it at its nerf state. So when I heard there was a massive buff, I was just like, So looking at the card, the poison now no longer armor breaks yourself.
Amazing.
Has a longer armor breaking duration.
Wow.
Gives 4 attack and 4 dexterity.
God damn.
And no cooldown on throws. But has its damage reduced from 750 to 500 damage. Eh, who cares when you're armor breaking. And something a little different. It has a whopping 1.5 second throw time. The longest throwing time of all lovable items, including traps. This means you pretty much have to adjust your timings, as many bosses have small windows for damage and go invulnerable often. Unlike Ogma, this item cannot armor break invulnerable mobs, so timing is essential to get this poison running. Aside from the long throw time and the low damage the poison deals, the poison holds the title of an event white very well. It adds a new playstyle for the assassin, and 500 damage may seem low for a poison, but hey, you're armor breaking the enemy, which leads to more damage output, and in groups it leads to a massive amount of damage added. So let's not forget the fact that it gives a whopping 4 attack and 4 dexterity. The Ogma is known to have an impressive bonus to survival with 14 defense and 60 HP built in, but this poison ramps up your DPS even more with the almost crown level of buffs. Well, it gives an omni level of buffs, we can say, to DPS. Let's head over onto the DPS calculator to fiddle with some DPS stats. The big 4500 DPS behemoth is from an unbuffed max DPS warrior set. Just for a little bit of reference, the orange line is what used to be the highest DPS set on Assassin with 3 parts of the Assassin ST set and crown, but with the release of this new poison, it is no longer the highest. As you can see from the creamy yellow line, it smashes the old set by 300 DPS. But wait, it gets even juicier than that. There's a dagger that performs better on low defense, which is a Corruption Cutter, which has its DPS all the way up to a whopping 4054 DPS at zero defense. And what does this poison do? Make enemies have zero defense. So you'll be constantly dealing 4000 DPS on an assassin. I mean, the bonus in attack and dexterity really do bump up the stats well. Just a typical set of Corruption Cutter, Wormhide and Bracer nets you a 3400 DPS assassin. And the crazy thing is the DPS is consistent as you have the armor break. Let's see in real gameplay. One thing I like doing is making use of the long throw time so I can armor break and then chuck a poison with a lower throw time. So they both stack up pretty well and absolutely rip these enemies. Like, look at this. Since armor break isn't that accessible, with this poison I'm directly benefiting the group as I bring these guys from 80 defense to 0, or Oryx from 60 defense to 0. So yeah, this armor breaking ranged Ogma is a great new addition to the collection of event whites, and I'm really glad I got my hands on one. And hey, I showed you the DPS charts, you can now join veteran runs or high requirement runs in Discord. This poison transformed the assassin from a leech to an absolute beast. If you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to subscribe and...